Rex.
Rex Manning Day.
Oh, Rexy, you're so sexy.
Hello, baby.
Call me on my car phone with a je ne sais quoi.
You say you need a little of my hula-la. I know you get lonely in your Canada bed. But say no more, baby, I'll be running every red. Say no more, more now, more.
Is
I'll bring my love in right to your front door.
Let's have a kissing, baby, so say no more.
Could you please not sing, Mark?
Hey, folks. hope everybody's here. This is awesome getting a bunch of folks popping on. So obviously just going to kind of chill. For those of you that don't get that reference, it was an awesome movie called Empire Records. And today is Rex Manning Day. Yeah, it was the eclipse, but also April 8th was the day that the movie was based around. And that's all. They had Rex Manning showing up, and it's just funny. So those of you really need to just watch it if you haven't watched it already. Coach, going to ask you to do what we said before. So just hang tight with all of your questions till let me get through some stuff. I assure you I'll answer most questions and definitely answer that question for sure. All right. So there's a bunch of you on here. We're going to start now just because I want to get this going. Anybody who is late can rewind it and watch it a little bit later. So just want to go through a couple of things really quick that are going through, just going through the pre-race email that we sent out already. So that's just going to make this really pretty similar to what that pre-race email was. And more importantly, it's going to keep me on track instead of just talking and going all over the place. So if you have not done your trail work or made a donation already, you have to do that. That is part of the entry fee for this race. The reason that we do that is because the Long Island Green Belt are absolutely fantastic people. Everybody that's there is a volunteer. They all do stuff. And they spend a tremendous amount of time out on those trails. And we use those trails. And we want to make sure that that's given back to those folks. So by all means, please do that donation, or if you have some time in the next few days, volunteer. So I think right now we're a little over 5,000 or close to 5,000. Really want to see that number go up. We'll send out another email probably today or tomorrow. And that will kind of just go through all the folks who haven't done it already. Let's see. Next thing is, So the carpool link. So the carpool link that we have up there is pretty simple. Basically, a bunch of you have already done it. Really, all it does is it will just give you the ability to, if you have room in your car, you can put a, you can put that you have room in your car, how many seats that you have, and where you're leaving from. And what that's awesome for is that if there's somebody who's in your neighborhood or somebody around, or they can meet you in that area and they can pop in and just be like, hey, you know, can I get a ride to the race or something like that? And this way it'll do all those things. Depending on what distance you're in for, Uber and, you know, Lyft and stuff like that is, I don't want to say it's not reliable, but there's, you know, it's the morning, so you never know. And we all know that that scheduling stuff doesn't really work. So rather than get burnt, it'd be really good to do that. Also, cupless race. So we are a cupless race. These cups, we will have some of these for sale, not a lot. I think we've only got less than 50 of these left. So bring something. There will be zero cups. None. Zero, no cups whatsoever for you to take a liquid out of a jug and put it into your face. No cups. So the reason that we do this is we've found that at some of our races that it is literally cut our garbage by over 75%. If you think of any race, the major thing that people are using are cups. And when you see soda or water or something like that, you'll take a cup, you drink out of this one, and then you'll take another cup and drink out of this one. Now you just use two cups. If you refill this cup, everything lasts a little bit longer, and we also aren't just throwing out a ton of trash. So please make sure you do something like that. Like I said, we will have some. We can take Venmo or cash, and we'll have some of those at Packet Pickup. Pictures, Ron is amazing at Goat Factory Media, and we love the pictures that he takes. I've run so many races, and outside of one situational picture that's kind of my favorite of Nicole and I, my favorite picture of me, Ron took, and he just has a way of, if you look through some of those pictures, he has a way of making it an art. The way that I like to describe it is that he finds an amazing, you know, a view that was just a great picture in and of itself, and then he finds a good spot as you pass by to put you in that picture. So it's not just a picture of you, and they're stunning. Some of you even still have them up as your profile or banner pictures from last year. So I can't wait. Hopefully that that'll be there. So going on to the communication stuff, we have a WhatsApp group and the Facebook group that most of you are already in or been around or whatever it is. So please, be a part of those. Don't abuse it, but you know, for little things like, you know, one year the buses were running a little bit late and we let everybody know. So don't worry about it. Just so we get this out here now and everybody listening, if the bus is late, we are not starting the race until the buses arrive. So if the buses are running 15 minutes late, the folks who are standing there who got there off the bus or who are on either a different bus or something like that, we're just going to hang for 15 minutes. We're not going to start the bus. If it's our fault or there's a bus that's, you know, not coming or something like that, or whatever happened, we're going to wait for that bus. So don't stress that. If you're on the bus, you're good. the rest of this is kind of chronologic as the rest of the week goes. So, Smithtown Running Company, is awesome. And we love those guys over at Smithtown and Sayville, and they're, in our opinion, the best, running shop on the island. And we really appreciate them letting us hang out in their store for 2 days and throw some stuff on. So, pop in 3 to 7 on Thursday and 11 to 5 on Friday, buy something else while you're there. Maybe grab some extra nutrition, check out a pack, shorts or whatever it is, and help those guys out. They've got some great sales that are going on there. Those are the ones that are listed. They'll probably have some more. Also, Cachava. So I personally ran a race that had Cachava. We reached out to them, and they sent us not one, but two full pallets. So we've got almost 1,000 bags of this stuff sitting outside. We're going to try and bring all of it down, and everybody is welcome to grab a bag. After the race, after everybody's already run, if there's still more left and you like it, grab another bag. Grab two more bags if we have them. This isn't a, you know, a one only thing. This is, you know, however many we have, you know, use them for sure. And we do have vanilla and chocolate, so you can choose, and then eventually that's where that goes. Picking up someone else's bib, we're still waiting for information on that. I apologize for not sorting that out, but I didn't really even think about it. What ended up happening was, is we switched insurance companies, and usually the one that we use requires a waiver for everybody. So if you have somebody else's signed waiver and you bring it in, that's proof that you were there. So what we're going to do now is just ask. We're going to have a spot. If you do pick somebody's bib up, we're going to ask that you just write your name, or we write your name next to it. And this way, you know, if somebody comes in and is like, hey, you know, what happened? We can be like, oh, you know, your wife or your friend or your husband or whomever, they picked it up. You know, they picked it up, and we'll know who it is and all that stuff. So, we don't anticipate any of you doing anything shady like that, but, you know, whatever, we just want to make sure that we have it. There, as of right now, will be, multiple timing points. We probably won't have anything at the start proper, but we will have something at the start. We're going to try and have it at the turnaround as well. We definitely will have something at the 25K mark, most likely. So we'll have one at Bowes Meadow. So it'll be the 25K and then the 75K for the 100K. It's a lot of K's. you get it, right? So it's going to be there. That's what's going to happen. Buses, we have the buses. They are filled. We are at max capacity, kind of a little bit over, to be honest with you, but that's just anticipating that there are going to be a bunch of you that don't show up because there already are. So we don't have any more spots. I'm sorry for anybody who was there. If you were one of the late signups, so you came in off of the wait list in the past 2 weeks or so, let us know that was you and that you forgot to get the bus, and we'll see if there's something that we can do. But anybody who signed up 2 weeks ago and before, you had ample opportunity and multiple emails coming out. Drop bags. So, Coach, I'm not even going to try and pronounce that last name. We do have drop bags. You'll have so the drop bags will be at one location. It's going to be at Bowes Meadow, or actually two, right? So it's going to be at Bowes Meadow, and then it's going to be at the Tierserver aid station. That aid station and the other one. So basically what we need you to do is write your stuff on your bib, on your bag, the way that we showed it. Depending on the folks that are there, they're going to try and lay it out in the most convenient way possible. Sometimes they throw them out and, you know, they do the best they can. I don't know how they'll do it. They might do it alphabetically. They might do it by bib number. But regardless, what will happen is they'll tell you how it is, and they'll be able to manipulate that. So if they tell you that it's alphabetical, you can look for your last name. If they tell you it's bib number, they'll look for your bib number. I think your specific question, Coach, was that the volunteers know that there's a post for an aid station. Yeah, I mean, they will. So that's, yeah, they'll absolutely will know that's their job there. and then the last one, just so you know, there is a finished drop bag. So we know that, you know, the bus is a long ride. So the bus, just so you guys know, you folks know that the bus is quite some time, because the buses aren't allowed on Sag Coast. So they can't go just that straight shot. That's about half an hour. So it actually takes a little bit longer, which is why the buses get there at 6:30. Or the bus leaves at 6:30. So that being said, what ends up happening is just, you know, get on the bus. If you want to wear a hoodie or if you want or something like that, bring a bag, and you can leave it at the start and we'll take it to the finish for you. So I hope that makes sense. 100Kers, obviously you're starting and finishing in the same location. 50K and 25Kers, bring your stuff with you that you would like to have there. At the finish line. And then what we'll do is we'll give you, you know, you could take a bag or whatever. You have a bag, we'll take that bag from you. We'll show you where to put it. And then we'll bring it to the finish line for you. So that way, you know, whatever it was that you wore, try not to make that too crazy, but that'll be there. So let's see. And as far as the bibs, we do leave town on Monday morning or Sunday night, depending on what it is. We're in Smithtown for the time that we're there. If we're not on trail cleaning anything up that's over there. So if you did forget something, try not to. But if you did, you're welcome to swing by and grab it. We'll have it. Anything after Monday, once we leave town, it is mail at that point. And I will be 1000% transparent. Any of you who have dealt with us in the past with that, we kind of stink at it. I'm not going to lie. What ends up happening is that stuff goes into a box, it goes into our storage unit, or it stays out for a little while, and then we don't get that email for a few days or a week or so, and then we forget about it because it did go into our storage unit. So just do your best to try and stay on top of it. If not, it's not that big of a deal. If you can, if there's something, and this is just advice for any race, not just ours, if there is a, if you're just like throwing stuff that's like maybe like a, you know, like some nutrition or whatever, put it in a Ziploc bag. Don't, you know, leave a bag that you want. We've actually had folks care more about the bag than the stuff in the bag. So just get rid of it. Like just throw a gallon size Ziploc bag with your name and stuff like that on it. And worst case, you know, we just throw out some nutrition or whatever. So, like I said, we try not to throw anything out and we'll return it all, but it's there. The thing is with the drop bags, the drop bags won't return until the aid stations are closed. So we might be able to get some back, but we also we can't guarantee any of that because we run fairly thin on volunteers for the most part. So if there's something that you want, you're welcome to drive and go get it. But you know, we're not going to guarantee that they're going to be back until then. So race day schedule, the packet pickup starts about an hour before, your race, right? So that's the really easy way to remember that. So 100K will be there a little bit earlier, setting up, but we're going to start, accepting packet pickup people at about 4 a.m. if you haven't already picked up your packet. The 100K start is going to start at 5. The bus is going to, arrive earlier than this, but we're not going to send a bus out until it's full. So we might send one bus. I think there's like two or three buses for the 50K. We might send one of them, but the last bus will leave at 6:30, and a bus will not leave unless it's full because we have so many folks. So it is not your, like I said, don't worry about it. If you get there by then, you know, as long as you get there by like 6:20, 6:25, you're fine. And then the packet pickup is going to happen at the location of the start of the event, not where you pick it up. We don't want you carrying all that stuff and going back and forth. It's just far too difficult to do all that. So it's just easier to have it done there. If you are a 50K-er and you show up with 100K, or we won't have your bibs with you. They're going to be, you know, either packed in the truck heading down to the 50K start, or something. So that's the only place that we can do it. If you want it, if you really want it ahead of time, come into Smithtown, and get it up and chat with whomever is there at the time. So again, 25, the 50K bus leaves at 6:30, the 25K bus leaves at 7:30. And then everything is there. Actually, seven. That might be a little late. We might update that. I want to find out and talk to the bus. That actually sounds really early for that 7:30. It might be closer to 8:30. 25Kers will definitely find that out for sure. So let's see the next one. Course maps. So the course map, I'm going to share this with you all here. On the website, there is a course map for all races. So if you look here at this plotter route, and if you go to, let me see if I can find this one first. Sorry. So if you look at that event there, right at that plotter route right there, you'll see, like the one thing I didn't have set. So if you look, you'll see the plotter route is here. And the cool thing about this is that if you scroll down on the bottom here, you'll see the key, right? So this is the red trail, and then the green and the blue. So what you can do is if you're running the 50K, you can just select the blue down here, and that'll give you that. And then the same thing with the 25K or this here. And then if you want to, you can look at some of the profiles that are on here. You can download the GPX file from here as well. You can download the chart. You can do a whole bunch of stuff from this plotter route here. I'm going to try. This plotter route is accurate. It's very accurate, except for one piece. And the piece of that is, anybody who ran last year knows that this sucks right here. This part here just isn't accurate about it going all the way around here. We haven't sorted that out. I'm going to sort that out probably on Thursday, just down there and check out and see what it is. I'd really like to leave some of this in here because it's kind of annoying, and that's really it. And it just gives a little bit more to the race of having to deal with some of the weather of the shore and whatnot. So, we'll see, but I'll let you know that on Thursday for sure. If though, that's a major issue for you, just use this and there'll be like a moment you're off course, not a tremendous amount. The rest of it is pretty darn accurate, 'cause I think I ripped this from a few of you last year. Yeah, I sure did. So this is way better than it's been previously. So you can look at this. You can look at all the things that you want to take out. And then this will be located, not there, but it'll be located here. Sorry. So this, if you go to, where the heck are we? Sorry. Oh, here. So if you go to the Shore to Shore website and scroll down, if you look at locations, this is the location for the 50K and 25K the bus pickup, the 100K start, the 25K start, and then the 50K start slash parking. So the start will be in a little different location, but you'll see it. This is just where the parking is. And then if you scroll down a little bit further, you can look at these maps, and the plot a route link is right here on the route on the map. You can just hit load routes, or you can hit plot a route, and that'll be it. All right, moving on. So going on from here, the course itself. So the course itself will have these. The course itself will be marked with all of these pink flags. These are, we've got thousands of them, and there'll be a ton of them out. Some of them most likely from I don't know exactly where, but from like maybe Tom's place all the way up will have reflectives on it. So that way, you know, for some of you late folks or the night time, you know, as it gets a little bit darker, and new 100K folks will be running in the dark for a little while as well. So a lot of that stuff will have all the reflectors on it. And then now, so they'll be marked with pink. And I saw a bunch of you commenting on Facebook or some other places, different ways. You should not have to worry about getting lost. There's plenty of, you know, there's plenty of flags, there's plenty of things, there's plenty of that stuff. What I will say though is that, you know, we have had folks remove them. I've swept course the next day, I've swept course the day of, and I even literally moments after the people who were marking some of the later stages in course, right after they put them down, people were removing them. So we'll do our best to get it done, and we'll do our best to hope that everybody keeps them there. But unfortunately, there's just, we can't guarantee it. So be mindful of the course and be mindful of the white blazes. The white blazes are there. I know they've been beefed up. I know they've been, you know, a little bit better than they've been in previous years, but they're there. I also know they're a little bit light. I also know that if you're not used to running on trail and you're not used to following white blazes, they're a little bit difficult to follow in a fairly easy setting. I also know that this course has a lot of twists and turns and a lot of, you know, decisions. So at the very, very least, we're going to hope that, you know, they just, you know, get it to a good spot. So I apologize if they do get removed now, but I don't, there's not much that we can do. The other thing is there'll be some of these arrows out there. There probably won't be a tremendous amount of them. We've lost a bunch over the years, but there'll be some of these arrows, so you can look out for these as well. Most likely, if they are up, they'll be up in something like this, where you'll see them with a couple of flags in them, and you'll know that's what it is. That's about it. Speaking of darkness, you have, and I don't remember when it was, but let me just check. You'll have some daylight time. You'll have some darkness in the morning. So 100Kers, you will need to start with a light for sure. And then you'll probably be okay with it till, I'd say it's going to be a little bit, it's going to be almost to Tom's place again. So at that point I would just hang on to it. And then what you can do is you can just drop it in your bag, at Bow's Meadow if you need to, and then pick it up on the return. You are going to be, I can't believe I didn't even look at this. You are going to be in, come on, here we go. You're going to be in darkness. Civil twilight begins at about 5:47. So sunrise doesn't happen until about 6:45, about 6:15. And then sunset is about 7:31. So you've got a solid chunk of daylight. So just please do me a favor and just pay attention to that. Make sure that you are, you know, that you're well lit. If you have something, this headlamp is called a Zipka. I don't know if they make them anymore, but this is awesome because it's just it's powered by AAA's. It's meant by Pizzle, and all you do is just throw it on. I don't use it as a proper headlamp. I use it as an oh shit headlamp. Anytime I'm on a run at night or something like that, this goes in my bag. And it's nice and easy. Like I said, it's just the headlamp portion. And at the very least, if you don't or can't find that or don't want to find that, go to Harbor Freight, get yourself like a $3 flashlight. At the worst case, you know, you have it and then that's it. I see all these comments coming through and I'm going to try and go through it. So let's see. Yep, aid stations, the aid station menu, it's normal aid stations and stuff, right? So like it's gonna be a lot. There'll be a lot of food. It'll get more as you go, and then it'll get, you know, more again as you go on for your 100Kers and stuff like that. If 50Kers, it's gonna be a little bit different. Not a little bit different, but there's gonna be a lot of stuff for you, but there just won't be as much hot food and all that stuff. Trash, please, seriously, please. I was just at a race on Long Island, and not that it was, it wasn't just, last year it was at a race and it was, had nothing to do with the event itself. But it just going around and there's enough trash and stuff like that in the trails and in the woods. So just please be careful with them. Bathrooms, there are bathrooms at the start area between aid station 1 and 2. And then at Bowes Meadow, there will be 2 portos, and then over at, let's see, over at, just past the 4th aid station, first date, will be another aid station. I think it's like 2 miles past there, but we're trying to utilize all the hard bathrooms that already exist instead of just getting stuff, you know, and wasting money and all that other stuff to get, portos where there are things that are on there. So pacers are not allowed for the 25K and 50K. As of right now, the 100K pacers are only allowed to pick up at Bowes Meadow and the landing. And the reason for that is Tom's place is just terrible to park at. It is actually really, really, really terrible to park at them. That's pretty much it for the blast through of this email that went through. So most of that stuff that you should know already. I have another email scheduled to go out to you folks tomorrow morning for crew. So the crew, it's just going to have a bunch of stuff on there that you already know, but you can just kind of forward it to them because it's addressed to them. So it's just a little bit easier and a little bit nicer. One thing that I want you all to remember, and you all are the racers at this point. I mean, I'm sure maybe there's some other folks on here, but as far as you being a racer, if you are wearing a bib, you're responsible for anything that your crew does. So please do me a favor and let folks know that, you know, if they read these things, we're serious about them. If you park in a place that we tell you not to park, we're going to DQ you. There's nothing that we can do to them, but you're no longer going to be allowed to race. And that's it. Unfortunately, things that we do when we draw a hard line, because Nicole and I run quite often and we run a lot of races and we enjoy running the races and we know how much crew means and pacer means and support and all that stuff. Nicole and I crew for each other all the time, which means that we have our children in tow. So we understand all of that stuff. Nicole has literally carried our daughters when they were, you know, babies for the most part to watch me run. And I've done the same for her. So we get it. The only reason that we do stuff like this is because of safety. So Tom's place is second or fourth aid station, depending on how you look at it. But Tom's place aid station is on a corner. It's just a terrible place to gather people. So we don't want that there. The first date aid station is second, the same thing. It's just on 454. A lot of you know where it is. And it's just, you know, it's not terrible if you're going for a run, but if you're, you know, crewing for people and there's going to be a you know, 50 to 60 or whatever people standing there. It's pretty crappy. So we've got some other places that we know you can go and see. And as long as they don't offer support in those areas in terms of, you know, like liquids or gels or, you know, or changing packs or any of those things, you're fine. Let's see. There's some other stuff. I don't remember it all. So I'm just going to start going through some of these questions really fast. Holy crap. There's a whole one. GPX ready. Coach, that GPX is on that plot of route link. And like I said, except for the last like half mile or so, it's spot on. how do we know if we have a spot for the bus? Check your receipt or your email. When you signed up, you should have gotten a confirmation email. You could search for Ultra Sign Up. You could search for that. Or what we can do is we can find, I don't know, let me check real quick. I mean, if this takes me too long, I'm not going to do it. But let me check this and see if this is really, if this will work. but I'm going to go on. Parking at Bowes Meadow. So there, that will be in there as well. Parking is pretty fine. There's a long road on Bowes Meadow on the west side, and that's the best place to park. We will send that out as well. No, there is not a tracking app. Unfortunately, the way that I kind of see it with that stuff is that those things are terrible. The tracking app is cool, but for the most part, it destroys your battery life, and it causes more issues than not, honestly. Sometimes what ends up happening is when we have had tracking apps, what ends up happening is if the folks who are counting on that tracking app, if something happens to it, they end up getting worried, they end up getting reach out to us, and then we get distracted trying to answer them because we know what it's like, and you know, we feel bad, and it sucks, but on the same token, we know they're safe and we're trying to put on a race and make sure all of you are safe. So just focusing on that one racer is a little bit difficult. That being said, I am going to try and do some live stuff, but that stuff just, it's all hit or miss. So what I can do is I might be able to try and see if we can have some live updates happening as you hit the timing points, but that's the only thing that we can do. And that's a big if as well, because of the same exact reason. Let's see, Nikki. Yes, it does. It does start at Heckscher. There are some things, and there are some things that are there that, that do say it on the website, and I feel bad. I'm sorry, but for the most part, yes, that's it. Yes, if you, let's see, sorry. So Nikki, if you go, Cruz can be at Bowes Meadow, third base and landing. Yes, if you go to the website again, so you can go to happilyrunning.shoreshore. Actually, let's just pop this up quick. You can go here. There's a section called aid stations. I apologize. This, the mileage is for top down. So I have another chart that I can send out as well that has the correct mileage on it, but you can at least look at the locations here. You can get the locations and you can get if there's crew access. So Tom's Place and First Date, there is no crew access. The rest of them, there is crew access too. Facebook user, yes, buses are full. Yes, the buses will be open. From my understanding, I'm supposed to confirm that. We'll find out. Lawrence, you're crewing for your runner and you don't want to breach any rules. Yeah. You can get to the runner as close as you want. So there's no rules. That's a really solid question, actually. So there's no rules in terms of what you can do for your runner within the aid station. So inside the aid station, you can give them whatever you want. You can help them. You can do all that stuff. All crew, we ask a few things. You can just repeat this to your crew if you want. Basically what we ask is that you stay away from the table of the aid station and the tent. If it's crowded, you're there. And if you're there and your runner is a fast runner and you're trying to get them to go fast and you want to help them out and like, you know, be an awesome pit crew, have at it. But you're there ahead of time, right? So if you know your runner isn't coming in for 10, 15 minutes, wait for the runners that are there to come through the aid station, let them do stuff, and then you can go over, you can get some water, and you know, you can fill up one of the bottles, so that way your runner can just come in, you can do that, and you can hand them. One of the things that's also helpful as a runner, if you don't normally do it, is look at the aid station ahead of time and just be like, hey, they've got peanut butter and jelly, pretzels, pierogies, they've got this, they've got that, what do you want? Sometimes runners just need to hear it and be like, oh shit, bacon, yes please, now. Or they might be like, ah, nothing's really sounding good, and you say something and they're great. Other runners might just need to go through and look at the stuff, so it's entirely up to them, or however it is, but you are welcome to go over to the aid station, do what you need to do. You can do all those things. What we ask you is that you do not do them outside of those areas. So outside of those areas. So don't do it if you are familiar with the area and you, you know, come down to the bottom of Kennequot, or, you know, you are at, you know, the top of Caleb's, or, you know, a parking or whatever it is. We ask that you don't do that. Those who are in the 50K, this is an RCAA. So it's a championship for the region. So there's folks in here that are really trying to compete and do something. That being said, those folks, if they do it, and we find out that they were getting support outside of that area, we will DQ you. Now, all of that said, if you're one of the back of the pack, we're not going to DQ you if somebody's like, hey, you know, like, I can grab that bag for you or something like that. We realize that, you know, some of you are out here to do this and do this as a fun race, or just to do this as, you know, something that you want to do. You're not winning anything. You're not doing any of that stuff to go super fast. That's fine. That is 1000% the runner that I am. I like running. I like running and besting myself. I don't care about placement for the most part. So that, if somebody, we're not going to DQ you if that's the case. What we will do, though, is if you are in that space and you say like, hey, I don't really care, I wanted to just, you know, I was really dogging it and I really needed something, and my friend happened to be passing me on this road, so I took, you know, I took a bottle, or I gave him a bottle, and we find out about it and say you are in the top race, we'll just remove you from, you know, winning anything. We'll still give you a result and we'll still, you know, whatever it is, but you just won't be able to win anything because you did break the rules. So I hope that makes sense. And I hope that's fair to everybody. We don't want to hurt anybody, but we don't also want, you know, we want it to be fair, and those are part of the rules. So speaking of rules, the headphones thing that we put it on there, and I know there was like a little joke that I posted on Facebook about, you know, the Bluetooth thing. So two things with that. One, the headphones thing, it's serious, right? So there's a lot of road crossings, and it's Long Island, so people are driving, you know, all over the place, and you know, most of you live on Long Island, so you know what it's like down there, and you know what it's like running along. To cover everything with road marshals would be impossible. So there's a lot of areas that you have to be a pedestrian and you have to pay attention. The Greenbelt has done an amazing job working with, you know, every municipality. There's crosswalks and all that stuff, so you have to abide by every law that is, if you are just on trail, that no streets are closed, no roads are closed, none of this stuff. So when you're running, run on the correct side of the road. When you come to an intersection, stop. Look, this race is not important enough to have anything happen to you. It just isn't. And I would hate to do that. And I've had to do it. I personally have been at races, or I've directed races, where people have gotten paralyzed, where people have died, where people have gotten hurt. And it's a terrible, terrible thing. And I don't want to ever do it again. I don't think that I won't ever do it again. I'm sure it'll happen, but I don't ever want to do it again. So please, please, please just be as cautious as possible. Let's see, the link to the map on the letter. Yeah, your bus pass is good. Sorry, your bus pass is good. For the 50K, the first aid station is third base at what mile? I'll throw that chart out there. I apologize. That really is valid information that you should need. I forget what it is. It's fairly quick. It's like less than 5 miles or something like that. And then The link to the map on the in the letter says 2019. If it is 2019, it's not the map. That map is actually really awesome, and I wanted to pull that up. That's this one, right? This one isn't a 2019 map. I think this is the one that you're talking about. You can't see it. Let me see. This one. This might be it. This is a really great map to give to your crew, and this will be in the crew This will be in the crew email that comes out tomorrow. Basically, what this is just a Google map. So what's really cool about this is that if you are out checking this out on a phone, you'll be able to say like, all right, cool, I want to go to Bowes Meadow. And you can just click directions, and being that you're on a phone, it'll take you right there. It'll show you what it is. This is actually what we use most of the time while we were even out there. So it's really simple and really easy, and it's got all the aid stations that are on there. And I'll add Tibur Sever as well on here for that. But it's got all the stuff on here, and this does have the public restrooms in here too. So I can add that to the GPX file as well, and we'll make this we'll make all that stuff a little bit better. That'll all be done tonight/tomorrow. So by Wednesday, all this stuff will be done. Let's see, the volunteers. There are no real rules. All right, the rules are, you know, you can't help anybody that's out there. So if you're, so 50Kers are really the only championship race that's there. So those rules, I can see if RRCA has them. If not, the rules there are basically just, you know, you can only help a runner within your aid station. And then pacer rules for the 100K. So that's a good question. So pacer rules for the 100K. You can use them. You can have a pacer. The pacer can only be picked up at Bowes Meadow or at the landing. And the reason for that is just because, like I said, because Tom's Place is trash for anybody other than the aid station folks. And you can pick them up. They, for the 100K, so this is one that I kind of struggle with. I don't really care, to be honest with you. We don't really care if they run in front or behind you. They are a pacer, so they're there to keep you, you know, safe. They're there to keep you, you know, on track. They're there to be there with you. They're there to keep your pace. So you're welcome to keep them. It doesn't matter which one. What we really don't want you to do is just, we don't want your pacer to mule for you. I think that's just, you know, I think that's cheating. You know, if they are carrying a bunch of stuff for you, if they're carrying, you know, like a couple extra gels, like if, you know, you as a runner and you have two or three gels on you and somebody else, you know, puts, you know, they've got a couple of gels or whatever, that's fine. Like, don't stress it. But if they're, you know, they're carrying your pack and your hydration and you're a runner that's going there, that's, you're cheating. So just don't do that. I hope that helps with the Facebook, with the, your name didn't pop up, for the 100K question. So, that's fine. So yeah, so you can do that. Just be careful with it and don't mule for your runner. That's really it. Michael, yes, you can cheer them on from wherever. I mean, it's, you know, we've got 30 miles of course that goes up and down Long Island. We're not going to tell you that you can't be anywhere. But you cannot be at Tom's Place and you can't be at First Date. But do me a favor, please don't do it in a shitty spot, right? Like, so, you know, if you're going to do it, pull over into a parking lot. There's plenty of spots. If you know the area, you know where you can go. Or, you know, good spots. You can't really go to you can't really drop down to the 50K. The 50K is pretty full. I don't know. Michael, you can send us an email at races@happilyrunning and we'll sort that out. Derek. Yeah, so it'll be marked. It's not the end of the trail. It'll be marked then. It won't. It's kind of difficult to do it. Basic, no, unfortunately we can't. I don't want to keep track of the cups right now. If that changes, I'll let you know. We don't have a lot. I think we've got less than 30. You can order them as much as I don't want to do this. You can order them at Amazon, I think. Let me see. Yeah, you can order them on Amazon. If you put in like Hydrapack cup, there's a bunch of them on here, and they're anywhere from, they're like 10 bucks or whatever. There's like $20 for three or something like that. I don't know. I'll check it out and I'll see if there's, I'll see how many we have, and we might be able to do something, but I'm not sure. And I think that's really it. Let me just check one more thing, because I feel like there was a couple other things that I wanted to say, and obviously I lost all that. If any of you folks have any question, now would be an awesome time to ask it. Yep, here we go. Yes, your shirt will be at the packet pickup line. Correct. No pacer pickup at third base. Yeah, I mean, that's real early for a pacer. Yeah, that's pretty early for a pacer. Yes. Perfect. Oh, what the frick just happened? Here we go. Yeah, so that's awesome. If they do, Mike, if you're on here and can confirm that, that might not be a terrible idea to throw something in there. If they don't, I'm going to reach out to Hydrapack and see if I can order some non-branded ones soon. Unless Treen Dog on Facebook, do you know for sure they have some? If you do, then that's awesome. If not, like I said, if Mike is on there. So volunteers will find out your assignment. Oh. All right, awesome. There we go. Never mind. So that is Mike. So Smithtown and Sable does have cups in stock. So should be good. We have some and they'll have some. So definitely do that. Volunteer assignments are going out again tomorrow, maybe tonight. Probably not, though, but soon. They'll go out tomorrow or so. I apologize for everything not being done already. I personally had some stuff happening over the past few weeks, and it's been a little rough on me, so some stuff has kind of been a little hectic. That being said, I think that's really it. So I can't find the rest of that stuff that I was looking for, so it can't be that important. That's all I got. Anybody else? Yeah, the cutoff was finalized. It should have been on. Hold on. Where the heck did my mouse? It should have been on that last email. If not, I can send out another email with that. Oh, that'll be on that pace chart. So I'll send that out again tomorrow. Thursday. Yeah, exactly. I mean, that stuff will be there. There will be some hot food. We're working on exactly what kind of hot food. Last year we had some chicken tacos, I think, that we had, some street tacos kind of stuff, and this nice black bean salad, and then some vegan options as well. And we're going to try and do the same stuff as well, because that stuff was pretty good. So it might be pretty similar to that, honestly. Might actually be the same exact thing, because it's pretty good. And it feels really good afterward. So that's all I got for you guys. Who PMs me just now? Sorry. Yeah, there. I hope somebody got to see the eclipse, because we didn't get to see it over here. So I don't know. All right, cool. So that's really all we have. I am more than welcome to hang on for another 10 to 15 minutes if folks have any questions. I have no problem sitting here and kind of doing stuff. I can't really think of anything else to let you guys know. For those of you who don't really care about any more information, you're welcome to split. One of the things that I will tell you, just for a second, a little story, I guess, is, you know, this race is one of those things that means a lot to Nicole and I, and we, you know, we do a lot of this stuff, you know, and we have taken over a couple of races, and this race means a lot, and it's kind of cool. We enjoy what it's become for a lot of you, and we enjoy the fact that it's this big thing that a lot of you folks have really started to you know, come to love and be a part of. And there's so many of you that are part of groups like Seldon Hills and Long Island Trail Runners, and man, there's so many other Smithtown and Sayville running clubs and all those folks. And you guys are all doing that stuff, and you have made it, you know, part of group runs, and you've done this thing that, you know, we didn't really anticipate that would happen. The first year we had a few people, and the second year was COVID, and like, it was a nightmare that weekend. We did it on both days. We had some folks run, and, you know, on Saturday, and some folks run on Sunday, and it was a lot, and it was just exhausting. And we didn't really know what was going to come of it. And the fact that we've gotten so many folks and we've sold out so fast, it really is wild. And, just so you know, there's a couple of things that's pretty cool with some of these aid stations. So, Tom's Place, Nicole's father, Tom, is going to be out there somewhere. If you know him, say hi. He loves doing this, and he is just an awesome dude, and he's super appreciative to have all of you out there, and he is super appreciative you know, to be out there and to help all of you folks, and that's really cool. Bo's Meadow is pretty neat, just because it's there. And then First Date is actually where Nicole and I had our first date, if you will. I mean, it wasn't really a date. We had run together a bunch, and we ran there. And then after we left there, we, you know, went and you know, had dinner or something like that. I think, I don't know whatever we did. We had some stuff. So, that's about it. All right. Questions. When will you know if you change the start time for the 25K bus? We are going to, I'm going to talk about that to Nicole right after here. I don't know why we had it at 7:30. I want to make sure that that's not, on the bus company. I just think it's silly to have you all stand there for so long. Now that I'm looking at it, I think it really should be 8:30, but we'll let you know. That'll go out tomorrow for sure. I'm sorry you are confused too. Pacers can be picked up at Bow's Landing for the first time. Yes, that is about mile 48. Actually, let me see exactly what mile that is. Let's see. Oh man, you guys ever work and stuff and then forget too many things? No, we don't have any more of those shore to shore hats. What I didn't, I have had those same hats. I do not have, hats with the logos on them. Unfortunately, I just wasn't really happy. We weren't really happy with the way the logos were staying on. Some of you, you know, have kind of expressed that they fell off or they got faded after a little while. So we were working on something else and it just didn't pan out. It might, I'm not sure. So let's see. Correct. Yeah. Bow's Meadow will be about 45. Yeah. Bow's Meadow will be about 45 in terms of, your return. Yeah, your return, where that's the first place that you could pick up a pacer. The short of short hats we already answered. Those were really cool. I love that hat, honestly. The hat is dope. We gotta try and figure out better ways to get it on there. Maybe next year. Maybe next year we'll hire a we'll get an embroiderer or something like that and get them done, because those were pretty dope. All right. We will also have the headlamp cut off there. So 50Kers, you really shouldn't need a headlamp. Last year we had somebody walk most of it, and I don't think he really even needed a headlamp, so he should be fine. But if you're going to be pretty slow, you should have one. The cut times are going to be posted for each aid station as well. Those are fairly loose, except for the ones that'll be highlighted or in bold. Those ones are the ones that you need to pay attention to. But it is roughly about 16 and a half, 17 minute miles. So you've got plenty of time. That's, your 50K has got more than plenty of time. And obviously if you get to, the landing, you're good. You're in. All right. Here we go. Can you repeat the bus pickup spot? Let's see, Alessandro, if you're still on there. Alessandro, they are on the website. Is there a formal document that you need to submit for your pacer? Yeah, we will be. That's a really good question. I apologize. I can't believe you dropped the ball there. Yeah. Pacers will be required to fill out a waiver and then wear a pacer bracelet. We will have those on at both of those aid stations, and we should have those for packet pickup as well. So if you're the reason that we need the waiver from them is because they didn't sign a waiver. So they will need to do that. Eileen, you will be stationed wherever. See if there's no, plot route has not changed, Mike. Let's see. What is it? I don't know what it is. Sean, as to you. I think that's really, I think that's it. So anybody who is still on here, if you have any questions, please send them to races at Happily Running. And the reason we ask that is because there is Nicole, myself, and a couple other people who will help with that every once in a while. Whereas if you email me personally, it's just me, and sometimes I either forget or it goes through. Same thing with Nicole or whomever. So if you do it there, it's treated like our customer service email. And even though it's mostly Nicole and myself, it's just easier because then we can both go back and forth with it and know for sure. Let's see. Okay. Sorry, I was reading something. All right, that's it. That's all I got. So, that's all I got. I don't know. I hope everybody has an awesome time out there. And I hope everybody is great. We're going to go through a bunch of this stuff again on race morning, but you know, it's just impossible to get through all this stuff. So this is a place that we wanted everybody to be able to chat, or to be able to have the opportunity to ask any questions that they can and to be able to retain the information rather than, you know, hearing it 10 minutes before your race starts, because that's never fun. And it's impossible. Your brain is far, far, far too worried about other things. So I hope everybody is getting some sleep, you're hydrating, and you're doing all that stuff, because if you're worrying about the race now, it's a little too late. That's all we got. And we will see you all on Saturday. Thank you.